Hey everybody, how you doing? Welcome to the dbGaP 10th Anniversary Symposium. Basically the idea is Mike Feolo, who I think you all know, if not, he's sort of the technical lead on dbGaP these days. Mike is going to give a few introductory remarks, talk a little bit about what has happened at dbGaP over the last 10 years, and then we'll have six lightning talks. A lot of content, obviously all of you have programs which discuss what is in those talks. So, and we should have time for a question or two after each talk. So, and we'll try to keep this relatively informal and try to get to the sort of social networking time as quickly as possible. All right? So without further ado, here is Mike.
Hello, can you all hear me? Thank you all for coming today. It's a birthday party, 10 years. I was debating on what I could show today. And one way to do it is to go through a bunch of slides and show statistics. But I want to kind of start with the slide that's usually at the end of the presentation. And I want to thank everybody who's made these last 10 years possible. And there's not a dbGaP without the GPAs and the DACs who do the approvals and register the studies. And so I want to thank them for the job they do. There's actually more people working on dbGaP outside of NCBI than inside of NCBI. So thank you. The OSP, they've given us guidance over the years and still do, and daily. And they're important to set the policy and to tell us what direction to go. And they're a pleasure to work with, and I'd like to thank you. The submitting PIs and staff, there is no dbGaP without the data submission, and it's not easy to give dbGaP data. We try not to make a specified format so that it's flexible, but that also means that somebody has to tell us what they have. We've never seen it before. It takes some effort, and I want to put out a thank you to the PIs and the staff that are submitting the data. There's a lot of NCBIers beyond the dbGaP group that work on dbGaP, and I want to thank you ahead of time for all the work you've done in supporting our group. Now, this is the time when I could go through a bunch of slides of statistics, but nobody wants to see that. So I'm going to do something that's kind of on the edge of my comfort zone, but I have penned a Seussian rhyme, and I'm going to give it my best shot. So please bear with me. In 2006, the development of an archive began. Matt Renat Jimmy Moss took the ball and ran. To develop a system for storage and dissemination, an archive without template or specification, an archive to store GWAS data for others to use, mandated by policy to stop all the excuse. Jim and Steve had a vision to collect this and that. It would hold individual level data, and it's called dbGaP. Looning, Kim, and Jack were also there at the start, transferred from within NCBI to do their fine part. Stephanie, Natasha, Anne, and Laura were hired in succession to manage submission, curation, loading, and accession. It was about this time that I showed up for the test because Matt was enticed to move back to the Midwest. Justin came to make genotype processing happen and decide in what format the data would wrap in. Ming climbed aboard to build an analysis viewer. At the time, the data points were much fewer. First study was ARIDS from an IC NEI. Then the pace of the submission started to fly. There was a project called SHARE and a project called GAIN, even though many questions still did remain. For example, what's a duck? What's a DAC? What's a DAR? Should we accession consent groups or not go that far? Studies named with acronyms such as DCCT edict, the growth of the data was hard to predict. Sometime before HMP examined their flora to help process documents, Kim recruited Mora. As time marched on, the team started to grow, and out to researchers, the data did flow. Some plans were implemented, and others did stall, such as the release of frequencies stopped by Homer et al. Projects named Geneva target CGEMS too, eMERGE, PAGE, GTEx, to name just a few. Since researchers are interested in p-values that are teeny, we bundled, linked them, and called it VGenie. Natalia was hired to process genotype data submission. She quickly did make that her primary mission. Adam joined the cause as NGS grew. How much sequence is coming? Nobody knew. See, it was about then that sequence started to flow. Is it Go ESP or ESP Go? I still do not know. As VCF and Plink files increased their count of mutation, Stefan began to work on genome curation. As OSP gives directions for what systems the system should handle, we create JIRA tickets for Gosha and Daniel. Svetlana joined the team in the month of July for loading imputed genotypes. On her, we rely. All the while, we process files and updated consent, flagging PII and ensuring quality content. As studies amassed and the sequence did grow, Rick brought us help to make BAM files flow. A great help to the phenotype side, I should mention, Wendy recently came from the RefSeq section. 8 years had gone by with little strife or grief. A developer named Monica joined our band for release. The contigs in place and the IDs all checked. 15 studies released, phase one top med project. 1,000,000.6 samples and still more in queue. I have no doubt this fine team will know what to do. Looking back 10 years hence, I can say it quite loud. We have done some great work, and of that, I am proud. And that's my rhyme. Thank you. Now, this is a party, so we are going to do a little bit of science, because it's a science party. So let's get on to the talk.
All right, great. Thank you, Mike.